You're now at the lab with Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory. My name is Nick Worm, and this week at the lab, bats. Imagine somebody walked up to you and said that one word, bats. Now, you don't really have to imagine much. That's the actual origin story of a recent Cold Spring Harbor discovery. Here's CSHL professor Dick McCombie.
A student from a course we've been teaching since 1995 and who works at the American Museum of Natural History was collaborating with someone in my lab. She was visiting and I always kid around with her, and I was pretty psyched up about bats at the time, and I pointed at her and said, bats, and she said, Dick, what the hell's wrong with you? I told her how interesting bats were, and she said, have you met Nancy Simmons? She's a bat researcher at the American Museum of Natural History. She's the one that got the bat samples from Belize.
Before we get to Belize, let's backtrack a bit. Bats, what makes them so interesting? For you and me, it might be their nocturnal habits or their appearance in popular folklore. But for McCombie, it's not their legends or lifestyles so much as their lifespans.
There's a general trend that the bigger the average body size of an animal, the longer they live. Bats are real outliers in that regard. Some species live far, far longer than would be expected based on their body size. And they apparently have a very low rate of cancer.
McCombie and his colleagues wanted to find out why. Enter the American Museum of Natural History team in Belize. They provided McCombie with DNA samples from two species of bats, the Jamaican fruit bat and Mesoamerican mustached bat. Back at CSHL, McCombie and his colleagues mapped the first ever genome sequences for these two types of bats. When they compared the genomes to those of 15 other mammals, including other bats and humans, they found that the genes responsible for bats' immune responses are dialed way down. As a result, their immune systems might work more quickly and precisely, lessening the amount of friendly fire on bats' organs and tissues. That could help explain their longer lifespans and apparent resistance to cancer. McCombie's colleagues hope their work will provide new insights into the links between immunity, aging, and cancer. And to think, it all started with one word, bats. Thanks for listening to At the Lab. If you like what you heard, please subscribe wherever you get your podcasts and visit us at cshl.edu for more stories like this one. For Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, I'm Nick Worm, and I'll see you next time at the lab.